Hi, mein Name ist Christoph Funder. I'm Project Lead at Zukunft Mobility and responsible for building up the hardware in the loop rig for validation of the AD system developed by ZF. And yeah, I joined Zukunft Mobility last year. And before, I was 8 years in the automotive industry as an engineer and team lead for building up real-time models, which run on different brands of this OEM and some suppliers on the hardware and the loop rigs. It was a really modular system we developed from scratch and really exciting time. But yeah, after these years and these different roles I had, it got a bit boring, and that's why I took this opportunity to join Zukunft Mobility in this really challenging project to bring a AD system on the street. And today I want to show you the application of CarMaker Hill with a ZF AD system sensor set and vehicle model from the SIL on the National Instruments hardware and the loop rig for the validation purpose. But before we start, I just want to give you a short company introduction and a big picture of the project. So Zukunft Mobility is located in Ingolstadt, and it's a 100% subsidiary of ZF, of the new department for this autonomous driving strategy of ZF. And together with the shuttle and mover companies and sensor companies and connectivity companies, we are working on bringing the AD system of ZF onto the road. Yeah, this is the AD system, what is developed by ZF. So it's consisting of the C, think, and act part. C means the different sensor devices for detecting the environment and creating a simulation model, environmental model out of this, and the think part. So there are perception and fusion algorithm developed by ZF, which is deployed on the Pro AI. So high computing ECU developed by ZF and together with NVIDIA. And at the end, the fused object list will be handled by the level 4 software, which is generating a trajectory. And this is handed over to the act part to steer, brake, and accelerate the vehicle. And yeah, everything is out of one hand. So that's why it's highly promising that the system gets on the street, because also the integration will be easier when everything is out of one hand. Here you can see the validation toolchain, the simulation framework where also our Hill is a part of. So instead of the SIL simulation, you can see here the hardware and the loop rig is used. And of course, we are using the same models which are created for the SIL out of the product as a digital twin. And saved in the data management, we are good comparable to the SIL simulation. And the output, the KPI output, what is generated by SIL and Hill can be compared. And so the SIL can be improved that we in future maybe get also rid of the Hill simulation in this closed loop to have the opportunity of the SIL that it's better scalable and can run faster than real time and it's cheaper. And as I said, we took over the SIL models, and now I show you how we applicated the SIL model at the Hill and found out the hardware and software real-time bottlenecks and how we overcome them and defined our proper hardware, which we can run our simulation model in real time, and how we changed the simulation model to run it in real time. So this is sensor set what we got from our SIL colleagues from Friedrichshafen. It's based on the IPG sensor sets, and the output of these sensors are used in special sensor models, which generate the same output or comparable output as the real sensors would have, and this is then connected to the device under test. So the SIL is actually together with the vehicle system one block. And yeah, in the beginning, we got this SIL simulation model and tested the real-time performance, as our colleagues before also did from the SIL department. But they said to us, you will never get this run in real-time because they had a real-time factor of just 0.2 here. And this means the simulation time over the elapsed real-time is smaller than one, and you need at least a real-time factor of one to let run your simulation model in real-time. So the software bottleneck was surely the sensor models, and especially the LiDAR. You can see here it needed nearly 100% of CPU load, and the GPU was just used 18%. Then we found out that we can split up the models, but then you just need another license. And while splitting up, the real-time factor increased to nearly 0.3. And we found out that it's approximately linear. And so we calculated that we need at least 12 sensor instances to let these sensor set run in real-time. The next step was to create the right architecture. And this we did together with NI and IPG. So the heart of our system is a NI PXI hardware in the loop rack. And this is connected via the interfaces, automotive interface, to the system under test. And of course, due to the lack of no existing possibility to plug graphic cards in the PXI system, sensor models have to run on a dedicated simulation PC, and on this PC we let the GPU sensors run, so the FreeSpace++ radar and LiDAR RSE sensors, and the connection is actually the 40G Ethernet, what we also use for the re-injection of measurement data to the system under test. And due to the lack of a missing graphic card interface, we are also not able to directly give for example, the camera sensor output through the graphic card output to the hill. That's why we have to send it via VDI over Ethernet to the model vehicle and environmental model here, that the sensor of camera gets fused, and the other GPU sensors are sent via APO protocol and UDP over this Ethernet connection. And we have additionally a host PC where we can control the simulation. So start it, stop it, and get information about the status. And we came up with this architecture because this can be used with Carmichael out of the box, more or less. And then we did final tests, final performance tests, and with the final sensor set from the first measurements in the SIL and the final sensor set, we calculated how much CPUs we need. So actually our simulation PC has two CPUs and three graphic cards. And as you can see here, LiDAR and radar, which are split up on, for example, the LiDAR is split up to 12 cores. So no single LiDAR can run on one core instance, and the camera is split up, each camera on one core. And you see here now the camera is more the bottleneck, but this can be improved by, for example, connection of the graphic card output of the SimPC to the hill, or a direct memory access between simulation PC and hill. And this was our final set and final performance test. And we could see that it's possible to run these models in real time. But the project in the meantime slightly changed. So now we just had to inject in the Think software. And that's why we just need FreeSpace++ sensor, which is running on a simulation PC, and the object sensor, which are fused object list and hand it over to the system under test, the Pro AI, where a trajectory planning is running on, and this gives out a trajectory to the acting models of the vehicle model in the CarMaker Hill. And additionally, here you can see a visualization of the CPU object sensors and FreeSpace sensors. And here you can see the red FreeSpace++ sensors and radar and LiDAR RC sensors. Yeah, and here we made a showcase with a bus shuttle in on the Aachen track following a car, and the loop is closed as shown before. And here is a visualization of the object sensors in these cones. And we are steering, braking, accelerating autonomously on this road. Yeah, so I hope this was interesting to you. And yeah, if you have a similar project or similar goals, and or you made different experiences, I'm glad to get some fruitful discussions with you. And here I just want to talk about the outlook. So what we are looking in a bit more deeply. So as this, the Hill system should be really reliable, and the real-time requirements should be met, we are doing measurement-based and analytical studies to see if the real-time requirements of the open-loop reinjection is met, especially focusing on the Ethernet connection. And we also verify it with Wireshark measurements, so comparing APO and UDP connection later on, and actually TCP connection for the open-loop reinjection. We compare with DDS and UDP. And from our actual knowledge and what we've seen and experienced, is out of the statistics that there are really as good as no data losses or changes, bit errors. But when you, for example, have man-in-the-middle or spoofing attacks on your system, we want to see if when we change data on the packet level, if this is handled by APO and UDP in CarMaker, or if you then need more reliable protocol like DDS with the underlying UDP or TCP protocol. And another thing we are I'm looking in is caused by that the scenarios are really influencing the real-time capabilities of the hardware and the loop rig. So we have a fixed model configuration, or we assume this, but with different scenarios and different number of objects, you can access, it can happen that your scene is not running in real time anymore. So the, for example, the CPU-based sensors, like the object sensor, is highly depending on the number of objects in the whole scene. And this, then you can really see easily your experiences from old scenes. You can predict with the number of objects if your new scene is also can run on real time. But the GPU sensors are depending on the rays and their reflections. So you have to simulate all the scene, because it's depending then on your vehicle position and the position of all the objects. And your this you can find out with comparison of the SIL simulation and the real-time factor there, and the Hill simulation, and when you have experiences and data out of old runs, you can maybe predict if your simulation will run in real time before you run it on a Hill, and you can save time and money and maybe remodel your scenes before. At last, I want to thank all the colleagues who worked in the project, mainly from the test system development team, but also from other teams who helped us. And I want to also thank our colleagues from ZF, who provided us with the models that we were able to start here. And I also want to thank our partners NI and IPG, who gave us early access to their, for example, Linux RT for PXI we urgently needed. And then we needed a CarMaker beta version also for the Linux RT on the PXI. And everything was delivered in time. And we got really good support from IPG as well as NI. And hopefully this will go on for our future goals in this project. Thank you.